Many people around the world are asking themselves how many doses of the COVID-19 vaccine they'll need and how often.
Protection from vaccines starts waning after a few months, so the US and other countries are expediting booster shots to fight rising infections.
We have booster shots for the whole nation.
People in a handful of places, including Chile and Israel, have even started getting boosters of boosters.
I'm getting the fourth shot today because I think it's important for protection.
Here in Tel Aviv, researchers have been conducting clinical trials for these fourth shots.
The good news is, preliminary results from the Pfizer trial show a fivefold increase in antibodies. Researchers here say that could mean increased protection.
We did not see any severe or significant adverse events.
But scientists are still trying to determine just how effective these fourth doses are and how long that protection can last. And some warn against rushing to add more boosters.
Regarding a fourth dose, I'm not convinced at all. I think that's why it should be done in a clinical trial.
So we looked at what the scientists know and why many epidemiologists say repeated doses shouldn't be given out so quickly. Scientists say vaccine effectiveness starts to decrease at around 6 months, and that's where boosters come in. In simple terms, this is how it works. We all have these Y-shaped molecules called antibodies. They are produced naturally by our body's immune system to help stop a virus from intruding. When a virus enters our system, our body responds in a number of ways. The first defense is by creating unique antibodies that bind to it in order to neutralize it or remove it. The COVID-19 vaccine helps the body to make these antibodies and evolve any existing ones and to keep the virus out. But after a while, numbers can dwindle and that protection fades. Booster doses increase the number of antibodies again and continue to advance the body's understanding of the virus. Now, researchers in Israel, where COVID vaccinations started earlier than in other countries, say the protection from those boosters is waning too, in as little as 3 months in some cases. Professor Gili Regev-Yochai and her team are working to determine how effective a fourth dose will be in renewing immunity loss after the third shot.
People here that came to this study are only 4 months after the third dose.
The doses are being tested on staff members who received a third Pfizer shot in August. Shirit Galper is a physician at the hospital.
I didn't have any large concerns participating in the trial. I think I would take vaccine every 6 months if that's what medically is recommended.
The trial has around 300 participants in total. Half are receiving another Pfizer shot, while the rest are getting Moderna.
The logic behind this is that we think that there may be a benefit of combining vaccines. We're hopeful that we will see something additive when we give or boost the immune response with something slightly different.
The shots participants got were the same as are used in normal vaccination cycles. Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson, which produces a single-dose vaccine, all said they were developing Omicron-specific vaccines, but those updates could take months to be produced. For now, drug makers are approaching additional doses differently. Pfizer CEO Albert Bourla said a fourth dose is not necessarily needed, while Moderna advised that those who have had 3 doses of its vaccine may need a second booster by fall. For these researchers, it will also take time to draw conclusions that can answer questions such as how long protection from extra boosters can last. But like many other experts around the world, Regev Yochai already says 4 shots shouldn't be given out to everyone.
I would think that probably we need to save these vaccines only to really the people who are very vulnerable and need it and not give it out to the whole population.
In other words, people who are immunocompromised, for example, are more exposed to the risk of getting seriously ill, even after vaccination. But for healthy individuals, some scientists argue 2 or 3 shots already offer enough protection for the worst symptoms. That argument comes as research suggests the Omicron variant may cause milder infection. Hospitalizations associated with Omicron in the US are lower compared to prior variants, though it could be too soon to make definitive conclusions. The number of daily coronavirus cases reached new highs this winter, and countries with high rates of vaccination are taking different approaches to second boosters. Some are racing ahead. Israel has offered them to at-risk groups. While Chile and Brazil are also moving to provide additional doses after initial campaigns used less effective Chinese-made vaccines.
Vamos a iniciar un nuevo proceso de vacunación masivo con una cuarta dosis o una segunda dosis de refuerzo.
But government experts in the UK said a second booster shot isn't a priority, and EU regulators said frequent shots could weaken the immune system.
It's not something that we can think should be repeated constantly.
While the World Health Organization cautioned blanket booster programs could in fact prolong the pandemic.
By diverting supply to countries that already have high levels of vaccination coverage, giving the virus more opportunity to spread and mutate.
For now, in Tel Aviv, researchers also recommend taking more time for reflection.
I hope that it's not going to be a policy of giving it to everybody, at least not yet when we don't have data. If we will learn that that's really what's necessary, it might change the story. But I'm not convinced about that.